Hello everyone, welcome back to Spar&Brawl. Hope you're having a decent day. So as always, I'm joined by my co-host Sam, and Gallup poll just put out a survey that I found to be quite interesting and terrifying about Americans' ability to, and if they can afford to access healthcare. So we're just gonna get right into it, and then Sam, so I'm just gonna read out of the article. There are just a few nice paragraphs. So just interrupt me whenever you want. So the first paragraph that kind of summarizes the main findings of the survey, and then in one of the paragraphs it tells the details of the survey, how many people, so we'll get to that. So it says that nearly one in five US adults, so that's around 18%, about 46 million people, report that if they needed access to healthcare today, they would be unable to pay for it. So these results are based on a new study conducted by Gallup poll and West Health. So I'll just tell you about the survey. So the survey was conducted from February 15 to 21st, so very recent. It had 3,750 adults, which is decent. Sometimes you see much less than this living across the 50 states, and it's taken from a probability-based panel of about 120,000 adults nationwide. So kind of not bad. I would say. But so let's get into some of the details. So when it comes to the unaffordability, it's different between, different ethnicities and different groups in America. So the current measure of healthcare unaffordability runs considerably higher among black adults. So 29% of them said that they couldn't afford it, and somewhat higher for Hispanics at 21, whereas for white adults it was 16%. So the average turned out to 18. Okay, so while 18% of survey respondents reported that they would be unable to pay for quality care if they needed it today, the same percentage also reported that someone in their household skipped. So the same percentage, 18%, said that someone in the household skipped care they needed for cost reasons in the prior 12 months. So this is pretty much during the pandemic. Around 80% of the respondents say that someone in their family decided to not get treatment that they thought that they needed it. And so the chances of any given household suffering from this form of healthcare insecurity are inversely related to annual household income. 35% of respondents from low-income households reported foregoing care in the prior 12 months. So a third of people who make less than 24,000 a year, that's pretty much 24,000 a year. 35% of these households said that they skipped, they didn't get treatment that they received, or didn't go see the doctor. That is five times the rate reported those from high-income households. So people who are making at least 180,000, of course, there was only 7%. Not so shocking. A few more, yeah. So, and then they have some other interesting stat, just a few more here. So with nearly one in five US adults foregoing some healthcare in the past 12 months, many Americans are cutting back on household spending to pay for the care that they're currently receiving. So one in eight adults say that they cut back spending on food, over-the-counter and over-the-counter drugs to pay for healthcare or medicine. The proportion doing this rises to about a quarter of those households earning less than 24,000. So a quarter of households who made less than 24,000, they said that they skipped food or drugs in order to pay for healthcare or medicine. And yeah, that's it. So after this, there are a few facts about, we can get into this if you don't have any comments about, if they agree with Medicare, kind of like Medicare for All and these kind of things. But yeah, so the main top line to take is that an estimated 46 million Americans, so one out of five almost, in 2020 say that they skipped medical treatment that they needed. So I mean, I found that to be extremely high and extremely shocking, and just, another piece of argument to the whole Medicare for All and everything.
I mean, they all specifically say they skipped it because of cost reasons, right?
Yeah, I think so. So
Okay.
here it was. Yeah. The same person as that, the someone that has skipped care for cost reasons. Yeah, exactly.
All right. So I would be interested to see a sort of a chart, perhaps, in showing it in comparison to other country other years, just to see if what's the pandemic, how much of the increase was because of the what percentage of this is because of pandemic, both economically and because of pandemic's health issues caused by the pandemic. So it would be interesting to note that. And again, as always with self-reported studies, there is always a bit of a danger of over people self-diagnosing themselves too much and saying that they needed medical care maybe when they didn't. Especially these days with the whole health industry 24/7 advertisement about how you're either dying of cancer or something else. So, there is that issue, but I would agree with you. Generally speaking, it shows a great level of, at least a significant number of people have health problems, and let's say at least 15% is real, and yeah, they can't get it.
Yeah, no, exactly. And the only thing about the whole pandemic point that you made, the only thing that they have a little bit is that last year during the pandemic and now, I mean, it is still during the pandemic. The figure was the same, around 18%. But yeah, they don't go further back.
But
And
that's
that's the,
interesting, though. So after a year of pandemic-related economic issues as well, it hasn't
it stayed the same.
about the same, yeah.
And once again, this is the average. So for black adults, it was at 29. Hispanics, it was
I was, oh, I must,
21.
I must, I thought that the difference between white and blacks and Hispanics would be more,
I mean,
the
it's
gap would
almost
be
double, but it's almost double between white and black adults.
No, you said whites were around
16, just
16.
whites alone, 16, and blacks are 29.
Oh, 29? I thought it was 22 or something.
No, sorry. 21 is Hispanics.
Oh, all right. And then the average, okay,
The
18. Okay,
average
makes
comes
sense.
at 18, and then they
All
also
right.
have it by
Yep.
age.
Yeah, that's more in line with what I had in my head before, like just by anecdotal evidence. But yeah, I mean, it's just another case that shows that the health, just the civil society is in disarray in a way that they can't even, afford health care.
I mean, the healthcare one, it just seems to me like to be the biggest thing. I think I made this argument once before that, I mean, one of the biggest wins in the US would be if somehow they have, Medicare for all or something along those lines.
Yeah, that would be huge. Federally. Yeah, that would be huge, and it's strange they don't, to be honest, considering that.
Well, let's see what Americans support. So these are not that new. So there's like two little paragraphs. So, what Americans support, what should be done. So they say that, for example, over 80% of Americans, including 70% of Republicans, favor setting caps on out-of-pocket costs for both prescription drugs and general health care. So, maybe people should be should can pay like a little bit out of pocket, and then after that it should be out of question. I
Oh, I
believe, if
see.
I understood this correctly. Right? And then regarding lowering the age of Medicare to below and lowering the age of Medicare eligibility to 60. Okay, bring it down to 60. 65% of adults support that, including 60% of political independents and 42% of Republicans. So I mean you can see it seems like more or less over the board. Maybe people, Medicare for all, and maybe that's been politicized too much, but they want something to be done about it. But however, other options are viewed quite differently by the major political party groups. I mean, let's not forget, I believe one out of three Americans don't associate with either of these two parties, if I'm not mistaken, something along those lines, just to bear in mind. But while 60% of all Americans favor making Medicare available to everyone, wow, that didn't even hit me the first time. 60% of all Americans, support ranges from 93% among Democrats to 19%
I mean,
among Republicans.
the thing with these polls, though, I mean, The problem with these polls is that you, the way they question, the way they frame the question, the people they ask, all of that. So, I mean, I always see on the Hill on Kyle Kulinski, everybody says, oh, more than 70% of Americans supports Medicare for all. They don't, though. They don't really don't. Because if they did really support it that much, when you vote on a whole range of issues. You don't vote for one single issue. It seems even if they do in principle, maybe they support it, they don't really care about it that much. So I don't,
Or I mean,
I mean, I usually
care,
don't
or if
buy.
they, I don't know if they care, or if it's politicized too much in this
Well,
way, or
you
you
know,
know, other things like, you know, the whole thing of Biden
everything
being
is
the most
politicized.
electable and all this, so it just distorts everything.
No, I know exactly. No, but distorts is a sorry to say that, but it's a nice way of saying they're idiots, and they are. I think so. You know, if you easily that easily you can be fooled by P. Like, come on, Joe Biden is not somebody. He's not a Machiavellian. Like he's not a smart man who's hiding his intent. Like, it's so obvious. The Democratic Party is so obvious in the way they hide and they use virtue signaling as a replacement for actual policy that I mean, if you're being fooled, it's your own fault at this point,
Well, I
first
mean,
of
I
all.
wouldn't go as far as you.
And
Sorry, finish.
I just wanted to say that even if, like, I don't believe that 70, I think people don't know really what they want. They just want a better, probably, healthcare system, but they don't really know what is Medicare for all. 70, like, Americans don't know what the fuck is public option or what is sort of a state-run
Some
system.
don't.
I mean,
Non-politicized people, like everywhere in the world, really.
yeah, exactly. Everywhere in the world, majority of public don't know about
And
this
look at
stuff.
us, we spend our whole days talking, our whole time talking about this, and we barely know.
Yeah, exactly. We don't know about, like, public difference, public option systems in different countries, and then you have one country that the state is, it's a state run, and another country is a state sponsored something. So yeah, it's all details, it's all that. But the idea that people support Medicare for all, which is, or people support regulation of guns, or people support anti-racist policies, or that type of thing. People don't support anything. People are very much dependent on their mood, on the day you caught them, on
Well, a lot of
when.
people support a lot of things, though, not everybody. I think you're generalizing a little bit.
Maybe I am generalizing somewhat, but I do think the majority of people are supporting contradictory things, and
But
they
it
don't
doesn't
know
surprise me,
why.
you know, if your whole day you're supposed to focus on, you know, something else, gain expertise and everything, and then you have, you know, all the media channels that talk absolute crap, and these political things and social things, like everything else, it's not easy to understand. You know, you're convinced that something is good until someone makes one point, and then you're like, God damn, I never thought about this. And I mean, you know, it's just, I mean, you can't blame people, and I don't think you're blaming people necessarily for, you know,
No,
not
I'm
knowing
not
better a
blaming.
lot of times.
No. I'm trying not to blame people. I might be a little, but no, I'm trying not to blame people, but I do blame. I don't think it should be reported that way, because that's, oh, the people all want good things. The people
Okay,
are
they're
all.
not saying it like that. It says over 80% of Americans, so based on their
Oh,
poll and
this is a,
stuff or
I mean,
something.
I went on a whole, like, sort of a rant on Kyle Kulinski and the Hill and
But no.
all the lefty, the idea that good ideas that I definitely agree with and I think are good ideas and humane ideas are popular, I think is a very suspicious and very, like, oh, everybody, even 70% of Republicans are for Medicare for all. Well, who asked them?
Yeah.
On which
Well,
day? On
to be fair
relative
here, it
to
said
what?
to favor setting the caps, but I get your point, yeah.
Well, yeah, no, I'm not focusing on this specific
Yeah,
study,
no,
to
I
be honest.
get you understand. I get your point.
I just wanted to, yeah, go on a
Yeah.
different rant. So I
But now
did.
that you said this rant, I think this part I'll add to your rant, which is that a lot of us, including Kyle and other people and leftists, there are some facts that have come out and they're like extremely good for us, and you know, I've heard people mention them and repeat those facts for like 5 years. I mean, you know, like we hold on to them and we're like sure it's 100% set in stone and there's like no kind of nuances. Kind of like the thing that we mentioned the other day, that it's assumed now that it's a given that it was the boycott and divestment that, you know, changed the South African government. Like everybody in progressives, a lot of people in progressives, let's say, they've just taken that argument and for sure. And I hear the same thing with Medicare, so I definitely
Well,
agree with you there.
with BDS, and to an extent with this, but less so with this. I think that one is a big financial thing behind it as well. In a way, that was a promotion of an activity that sort of really, like, you know, it redirects the energy of the movement to something that I think is largely useless, rather than, let's say, lobbying politicians or something like that. It focuses on changing behavior of the people and communities. So I think, that was the point of that. But then, I mean, that's a big argument as well. So,
but I think you can generalize in a sense that saying it's clear that most Americans, especially if so many are skipping, that they're not happy, of course. And who would be happy with that kind of system of Medicare and that they want what that kind of healthcare system? And of course, they would want better. Now, you're exactly like 60% favor Medicare for all. You know, if it's that strong, how come we haven't seen something come out of it? You know, Bernie positioned himself fully on this. But, you know, I'm sure people will counter and be like, you know, but the media distorts everything. And on top of that, there are other issues that come into play. So all of this.
And all of that is true. But again, I'm just saying, don't claim majority of people think that or this or the other.
But you could say, like, it does seem, I mean, for sure, majority of Americans do appear to not be happy with their healthcare, which is clear. And a lot definitely want a different system, including, I'm sure, a lot literally want Medicare for all.
This is just like when, like, Fox News hosts or whatever, they say that the Christian people of America all think that. You know, a lot of people call themselves Christian. They don't necessarily agree with the specific crazy version of the Christianity you agree with, you know? So, I just think it's a bit of a, too much exaggeration. But otherwise, it's a study that clearly shows that a lot of people are in need. They want a better healthcare system, and they can't use it right now because they don't have the money. So,
definitely. Yeah. But okay, that's that. So I think this ties in pretty well with the story we just did right now about the Ben Shapiro and Ro Khanna minimum wage debate. So if people haven't seen that, can go and check it out, and it really shows, you know, the state of America and how a lot of the arguments made by Ben Shapiro make absolutely no sense. But yeah, anything to add, Sam, or should we wrap it up?
No, I think I added as much as I could. So yeah, let's wrap it up before I probably get killed for this. But yeah, whatever.
Yeah. Okay, well, thank you very much for watching. Please like and subscribe if you like this video. We'll put a link to this survey in the description box, of course. So thank you, and we'll see you in our next video.